Universal Parenting Clinic is the show.
Get your copy of Parenting Without Tears.
Parenting Without Tears. Buy your copy right now.
Welcome to this week's edition of Universal Parenting Clinic. On this show today, I'll be discussing why it is important to watch your actions and reactions in parenting. How you react to issues affecting your child or an unacceptable behavior can determine the outcome. Your attitude and efforts can make things worse or better. Don't allow your emotional reactions at several moments to becloud your sense of parenting responsibilities and judgment. There is the existence of the usual struggle of wills, especially as the child grows from the age of 10. The parent's will and the child's growing wills and desires may sometimes be in conflict due to differences in experience, age, social levels, exposure, external influences, and pressure. Most parents I discuss with explained numerous experiences faced with children once they attained that status of a teenager. It is a very crucial age in parenting. It is an age when you can gain or lose that child completely or partially. It is a time when many children think they have arrived, that they want to exercise their freedom and free will. A time when they mingle with age mates. A time when they are exposed to the world. This is a topic that will be treated specially on this show. How to cope with your teenage child successfully. It is the age when sudden growth gives the sense of maturity. A time when that sense of self seeks constantly for expression. A time when temper rises. A time when children are exposed to the danger of misbehaviors. A time when the peer pressure and peer group can reshape all the good manners from childhood. It is a time when your parenting control and leadership may be threatened. A time when your parenthood may be tested and challenged. A time when you may lose your cool several times. This do also extend to adolescence and maturity in some cases too. These are trying times. Times when your elastic limits and parenting patience could be stressed beyond limits. There is naturally the inclination to want to enforce one's way over the other. The general reaction, opposition, competition, and sometimes confrontation that goes with such clash of wills between the parent and the child or children must be well managed. The parent in most cases wants the best for the child. The child, on the other hand, sees himself or herself as being capable of his or her decisions and actions without any undue interference or parental control. He thinks he is of age to have a girlfriend, and she thinks she is free to start dating. You think that's abomination at 13, or at any age for that matter, before maturity. He or she thinks, on the contrary, that she could handle much money at will. Remember the story of the prodigal son. Most times, it may be due to the limitation of the level of the child's understanding of life situations. It may sometimes be because of things learned, noticed, taught, and seen with peer groups or through the social media, or as the child begins the development of personal hormonal changes, or as the child suddenly realizes the advancement in age and education. The urge to gain self-independence and control also contributes immensely to the power struggle and clash of wills. It must be realized also that the demands of different generations affect the individual desires and decisions too. And these play vital roles in the desires and wishes of the parents and their child or children. For example, the demands of the children of the 21st century in technology, phone usage, social media, sex orientation, communication, and dress code, among others, will differ from that of the experiences of the parents of the 17th to the 19th centuries. This may lead to disobedience, insubordination, disrespect, annoyance, quarrel, conflict, and of course, the need for disciplinary measures to address the situation. This apparent challenge of parental control and authority usually leads to rebellious behaviors by some children and ultimately results in the existence of unnecessary power struggle, domestic tension, hatred, and conflicts between children and their parents. Unfortunately, this generational problem, rather than disappear, has increased in range and tempo or intensity in several families. And this generation is equally afflicted with the same tendency towards willful disobedience, youthful deviance, and arrogance.
That's a parenting clinic is the show.
Get your copy of Parenting Without Tears.
Parenting Without Tears. Buy your copy right now.
This is, however, not an unusual development. The devil manipulated Adam and Eve in ages past, as recorded in the book of Genesis in the Holy Bible, with the incentive that eating the forbidden fruit will make them be like God and do as they liked. They had the forbidden fruit, contrary to the instructions of God, their parent, and they were lured away into sin by the inordinate desire for enthronement of their self-will, which made God to pronounce his judgment. The influence of peer groups and several other factors cited in topics on this show already, and those listed in the book, Parenting Without Tears, especially the position of the top parents on children nowadays, equally act as the devil's advocate to lure children into similar behavioral pattern. Please note this with every sense of seriousness. Every parent must be ready to deal with this development with caution and calmness, because with carefulness, the faith will fade away with age and growth as well. However, if not properly handled, this is the stage when the child may be lost, a period when the child may develop series of negative attitudes and confrontational dispositions, with mental illness creeping in, and such a child may lose focus totally in life. We have the power to choose our thoughts, actions, and reactions in life. When confronted with choices, please go for the positive and reasonable thoughts, actions, and reactions, not the negatives. Think positive and avoid reactions based on emotions and the attitude of that child that can create unguided and unguarded negative reactions and effects in your child. Be your good self. Be calm. Be matured. Be sensible. Be reasonable. Calm yourself and take the best action and decision. Let your reactions be guided and motivated by reason, not emotion. The faith will soon fade away. Your child is still your child, and you still remain the parent. May the Almighty God guide you always in your actions and reactions. Thanks to our numerous friends on Facebook who are watching this show passionately every week. Thanks also to those who have subscribed to our YouTube channel freely. Thanks to those of you who have bought your copies of the book, Parenting Without Tears. I also thank those who do press the thumb up button regularly, those who ensure they leave feedbacks for us regularly too. I do hope sincerely that you too will join this group of people today. Please subscribe now and follow us too on other social media platforms. That's the show this week on universal parenting clinic. I believe strongly that through this universal parenting clinic and with proper understanding of the book Parenting Without Tears, together we all can promote wellness in families and in the world. We can stop the tears from children, parents, and families. We can kick racism, fraud, incivility, corruption, wickedness, several addictions, violence, and the series of antisocial behaviors out of our families and the whole world. And at the same time, we can promote all the positive desires and aspirations towards the well-being of the children, parents, and the world at large. Till I come your way again next week, by God's grace, I am the parenting advocate in the house, Michael Gbenga Bibilari, MGB, Mr. Parenting. Let your actions and reactions be well guided in parenting. Think parenting. Be positive in parenting. Talk parenting. Be passionate about parenting. Don't just be a parent. Stop posturing. Be a responsible parent. A real parent. A parent indeed. Parent well.